Natasha Belling with a 10 News iUpdate. Schools across New South Wales are deserted with teachers walking off the job. The Teachers Federation defied an order from the Industrial Relations Commission not to strike, and as a result, Education Minister Adrian Piccoli has vowed to have the union fined $10,000. Teachers don't like a government plan to give principals the power of control of about 70% of a school's budget and hire up to half of its staff. Australian athletes are mourning the loss of one of their own. Sprint champion Daniel Batman was killed when his vehicle veered off a highway southeast of Darwin. The 31-year-old Olympian had two children with his ex-wife and fellow sprinter Nova Peresniebo. It's believed he was attempting a comeback this year in the hope of making the London Games. Three people have been assaulted during a terrifying home invasion in Brisbane. Five men burst into the Carindale property with a firearm and batons at around 10 o'clock last night. Two residents sustained cuts and abrasions to the head, while another received minor injuries. Australians are expected to pack on 15 million kilos of body fat this winter. The findings come from a national survey of more than 1,000 people commissioned by health authorities. It found cold weather makes us exercise less and seek out high-calorie comfort food. US President Barack Obama and his wife Michelle have dished the details on their very first date. The day-long extravaganza in 1989 included lunch at an art museum, a walk and a Spike Lee movie. The YouTube vision was released to promote a competition to win dinner with the couple. And posh, scary, baby, sporty and ginger have reunited in London to launch a new musical inspired by their songs. The Spice Girls, one of the biggest girl groups of the 1990s and split up 12 years ago, the women launched Viva Forever at the same hotel where they filmed the video clip for Wannabe. Details on those stories, plenty more, 10news.com.au.